The governor has made it official. The voter ID law says that anyone going to vote has to show a valid state issued ID first. And if they don't have one, the state will then issue them a free voter ID. In the state of South Carolina, that is now law. Or is it? Okay. Governor Nikki Haley celebrated the signing of the voter ID bill, but the bill itself is far from ready.
First of all, it's got to receive Justice Department approval before it can be implemented in South Carolina.
After the civil rights movement, under the Voting Rights Act of 1965, South Carolina, like other southern states, has to get approval when it changes the voting process. But that is just the first hurdle, according to Conway Belangia with the Greenville County Voters Registration Office.
The legislation provides for that ID to be issued to people who have not already received theirs, free of charge.
That ID can simply be a driver's license.
I came down to the DMV because today is my birthday and my license had expired.
Mary Joy Lepak had to pay $25 for her license. But since she will soon be using that ID to vote, could the cost of the driver's license be considered a poll tax, having to pay money to be able to vote, which is against state law?
So why do I have to pay, I guess, is the question. Why do I have to pay for my license and then someone else can just get a free photo identification? I think there's a little question there.
Another problem this voter ID bill faces is who is going to pay for it. The state, which is in a budget crisis, will have to find money to pay for the creation of a new identification system for the estimated 178,000 voters who don't have a driver's license.
Right now, there is no money in there for this project in the appropriations bill.
No money and plenty of questions about a bill now already law.
Another big hurdle for this bill is that every poll worker in the state will now have to be trained on what IDs are legal, also on what to do if there is a problem. It is a possibility that everything could be in place by this November's election.